Freshwater Fishery Society of BC, Go Fish BC on Shaw TV with your host Brian Chan from the Freshwater Fishery Society of BC. Go Fish BC is brought to you in part by Freshwater Fishery Society of BC, River City Marine, and Surplus Herbie.
Welcome to this week's episode of Go Fish BC on Shaw TV. Actually, this week, it's all about bugs. It's all about the aquatic insects or invertebrates that trout feed on in our local lakes. So I've just got my little handy dandy kitchen strainer here, and I'm just gonna show you exactly how nutrient rich, how diverse the aquatic food supply is in our local lakes in and around the Kamloops Merritt area or throughout the interior regions of British Columbia. So just with this little strainer, I can scoop down, and we're really close to shore here in the shallow water. And I've got damselflies in here, I've got mayflies, I've got chironomid larvae, so I'm just putting them in my little bucket here, and I'm going to catch a few more bugs doing this, and then we're going to have a close-up look at them and quickly look at some of the life cycles and some of the things you need to know about these insects in order to imitate them if you want to fly fish in these local lakes and catch fish. So I've used the kitchen strainer and made a few passes through the edge of the shoreline of the lake here, and you can see when you look at the edge of the lake there's lots of emergent vegetation as well as riparian vegetation, so lots of habitat for the different bugs in the water as well as on the edge of the lake. So one of the most staple food sources of trout and char in our local lakes are gamma shrimp and hyalalla shrimp, and so shrimp form a very staple food source. It's what gives our trout that deep orange red flesh color, the carotene in the carapace of the shrimp, and so they're a very, very important food item. Trout can eat them year round. That's why fly fishermen should always have shrimp patterns in their fly box. We also got a whole bunch of damselfly nymphs, both immature nymphs and mature nymphs. So mature nymphs being nymphs that are going to hatch this year, and the immature ones will hatch next year. The key piece of habitat you need for damselfly nymphs is you need to have lots of emergent vegetation like this long-stem bulrush that lines the edge of the lake, because when the damselfly nymphs are fully matured, they swim just under the surface of the lake to the long-stem bulrush, and then the nymphs crawl out and hatch into the adults. So damselfly nymphs, you'll see they come in all different colors and sizes, remembering that they'll spend 2 years in the nymph before they'll emerge as the adult. And then finally, we've got some beautiful Calabatus mayfly nymphs, which are the very most common mayfly that you'll see in our interior lakes. And they again live in the shallow shoal area of the lakes, just like all the other bugs do in the lakes. It's the shallow water that produces the best habitat. So we'll have a look at these mayfly nymphs. They're hatching usually, as their name implies, in May and June, depending on water temperature. Everything is driven by water temperature, and we need to understand that if it's a cold spring, the hatches are going to be delayed. If it's a warmer spring, they'll be sped up and they'll be more compressed. So I hope you picked up a few tips on today's episode of Go Fish BC on Shaw TV. It's all about bugs when you're trying to fly fish and matching the hatch. See you next week.
Freshwater Fishery Society of BC, Go Fish BC on Shaw TV with your host Brian Chan from the Freshwater Fishery Society of BC. Go Fish BC is brought to you in part by Freshwater Fishery Society of BC, River City Marine, and Surplus Herbie.